What's poppin', YouTube? Know it's dark out here. Here I'm at Walmart. Still here. I don't know what to tell you. You know what it is. I stick the camera up in there, take a picture of my trailer. Looks like they had it half empty. And it's almost 4 hours in detention. 1 more hour, be 4 hours. Is this broker gonna pay me for this? Doubt it. Everybody's lying to me. Yep. Dispatcher's lying to me. He's kind of like sleeping. Different time. Lady behind the desk says she don't have a clue. Try to get me out as soon as possible. Calm my nerves. Go down to the trailer. Trying to get the forklift's attention. Shoot him a couple of dollars. Yo, get me unloaded, man. I gotta go. But I can't catch him. It seems like they just take a pallet off and then they unpack each pallet. That's what it seems like to me. Clock is running out. Walmart don't want you staying here. So, this is what pisses me off. I guess it pisses all truckers off. All truckers. So, walking up here to the trailer. See if I can catch the forklift driving at, you know. How much longer? I don't know. This is crazy. There's another driver over there. He's been walking up, seeing if his trailer's empty. Three hours from the house. I might have to go on paper log. Sorry to say. Fuck that. But is this the way trucking's supposed to be? Maybe. Was it worth the trip? I don't think so. To be away from my family. Here I'm at the trailer. Got the red light. Still unloading. I'll let y'all see. That's it. That's my trailer. I didn't have much stuff on it. I don't know. Listening for a forklift driver, find out. There's no movement in there. Basically, everybody's off. Home, enjoying Thanksgiving. Trucking. They knew they have appointment times. Why not unload my truck on time? You rush to get here on time? And what happens? you wait. Almost like the army or any military, hurry up and wait. Shippers and receivers, ELDs, retention pack, brokers, DOT, all fields that the driver don't have control of. No say so. What we gotta worry about, hitting people. Fuel. Permits. Taxes. Physicals. Miles per gallon. Maintenance on your truck. Tires. What next? Does life get better? Does this situation get any better? Does it? Do we get unloaded, loaded at a timely fashion? Who's going to pay for the time? Don't know. Let me go upstairs and see what this lady lies about this time. I wish I could put y'all on camera. Y'all can hear it, hear the BS. But I know Dallas Cowboys is getting their ass whooped. Well. It's also been killing people.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not worried about a computer taking my driver. It won't happen.
Yeah.
I felt sorry for all the, you know, I just thought about that.
You the manager?
Nah, I wish I was.
I'm getting ready to try. I'm trying to find out if I can just leave my damn trailer here and come back and get it anymore. You been here as long as me?
Just about. You've been here longer than me.
We're the only two out there, right?
That's right.
Okay.
I'm sorry, guys. Man, you're door 316, aren't you?
Yes.
Okay. Now, normally, they like, will get on to us if we go to doing all, you know, like, they don't want us to come, you know, like.
All right, how about this? You don't tell us anything. Well, you don't give us permission. Where's the door to go to the dock? Me and him will just go out on the dock ourselves.
Listen, wait here and give me. I swear I'm going to be on my hustle. Like, just give me a few minutes.
And we'll say you didn't know nothing about it.
Well, what I stuck my phone up in there, took a picture.
Are you empty or?
No. Nah. I'm halfway empty.
Oh man.
And that's almost 4 hours.
I was 4 hours.
Yeah. I'm almost 4 hours.
This is by far the worst experience at Walmart I've ever had.
Really?
No.
Well, 3 hours in and out in Walmart. I was expecting three, so.
Well, hell, I could have told you that wasn't going to happen. For my whole time that I've been up here, I've never seen a truck come down in 3 hours.
The cool part about this is I do have to head back past here to pick up my load in the morning. We'll Will it be unloaded by 5 in the morning?
So you must live here. You live here in South Carolina.
I live in Texas.
Oh.
I'm just trying to get a TA to get Thanksgiving dinner.
Oh, well. I got so much food waiting for me. Family already had fun and everything.
Wow.
I'm in Georgia.
You live here?
No, I live in Georgia. So that's 3 hours away from here.
Well, that ain't too bad.
That's not bad.
Well, you can't leave your trailer here for that day.
Nah, I don't want to do that because I probably take.
I'm just looking at going 40 miles.
I would have did that already. I would have left.
Well, I mean, I don't want to leave my brand new trailer here. I mean, I just bought this truck and the trailer. Got rid of my W9 because I couldn't afford it.
Right.
I couldn't afford the fuel in it anymore. So I got rid of that and bought a new Kenworth. And I figured, well, shit, my old trailer's all beat up. I might as well buy a new trailer. I don't want it all beat up.
Right.
And it was 2 months old. I don't want that thing beat up.
I feel you on that. You would have watched your trailer. No doubt.
I about had a freaking cow the first time they scuffed the floor.
And they banging around in there. Yeah. I didn't know it.
I had to get out of one place because they weren't hitting the walls, but it just sounded so bad. I was like, all right, I can't even be in my truck for this.
Oh, man. I don't know.
All right, guys.
Clock is running out.
Yours probably going to be done around, now don't hold me to this now. I think around 8:30.
Tonight?
Yeah, because they said yours is coming off pretty smooth now. But 2016, it's gonna be a little longer than that.
All right, so you're at least, it's 4.5 hours since you're starting to go smooth.
I'm just hoping.
At least a half an hour before things start rolling.
Wow. All
right, so it'll be empty in the morning.
Sir?
It'll be empty in the morning.
Oh, certainly. Yes, sir. Yes.
Because I'm going to be back here around 4:35.
Okay.
So I'm leaving for the night. I'm going to get something to eat. I'm not waiting
yes,
for
you. Yes, sir. Okay. Well, I'll let
you. Stop calling me, sir. I'm not that daggone old. Make me feel old here.
It's just.
I know.
Naturally do that. Okay, so I've got your number here so that they can call you when your truck is ready. And then when they come up here, I'll call you. But if you want to leave it here for the night, that's okay too.
Wait, he said it's okay?
Oh, I already know it's okay.
Okay. Just make sure you know where it's parked so I can come in and
yes,
find
sir.
It.
Yes, sir. They'll know. When you come in here with the first shift ladies, they'll know where it's at.
And they won't have a problem letting me out of here without a gate pass or anything?
Make sure you ask for one.